RIT astronomy expert Brian Koberlein, and we're talking about Mars this morning. A blog he wrote called The Edge of Wetness, which got me laughing because I knew it was a reference to an old Johnny Carson routine, take off on the edge of dark, edge of darkness was the
soap
opera.
No, it was The Opera. Edge of Wetness.
Yeah, The Edge of Wetness is what Johnny Carson did. So anyway, how does that relate to Mars?
Well, one of the things that we found recently on Mars is liquid water.
That's huge, because we knew that there was water in frozen form, right? We thought.
Right. Mars is very cold. The atmosphere is it's less than 1% of what our atmosphere is. Mm. And so any ice would immediately evaporate into gas, like dry ice here on Earth. And so we hadn't thought that there would be liquid water. But we saw in these gully areas what looked like water flows. Mm. And we couldn't be sure, but recently observational data has confirmed that what it's doing is depositing salts. Mm. So this is briny water that is flowing through these kind of gullies, kind of like sponging.
Because it's briny, is that why it isn't necessarily in the ice form? Because it's a higher melting point, or lower melting point?
Once you have it, it's very saline. It's got a lot of salt in it, and so the freezing point is higher, and so it's able to be liquid.
You got to wonder what it's flowing through then, if it's briny. I mean, there must be something that is, that's perhaps leaching. Maybe some sort of minerals of some kind, right?
Right. There seems to be salts in the area, and we think that some of the moisture from the atmosphere is kind of condensing into the salts and then creating the brine.
So talk about the overall significance of this. This changes a lot about what we know about the planet. And, you know, people have been for years wanting to go to Mars, but we know that that's a one-way trip.
So far.
So what... what does this mean?
Well, the reason people get excited is that everywhere on Earth where you see liquid water, you see life. And so this excites people about the possibility of life on Mars. It also poses some serious challenges, because the one thing we don't want to do is we don't want to be the alien invader and infect Mars. Mm-hmm. And so there are certain sterilization standards that you have to make sure there aren't any bacteria or living organisms on your spacecraft. We don't have any spacecraft that matches that standard to go where there would be liquid water.
Wow.
But we've landed there already, unmanned.
Right. We've landed there in dry areas.
Okay.
So the Curiosity rover, for example, is less than 30 miles away from one of these wet areas.
Wow. Mm.
And could, in principle, drive over there. But they're not allowed to by international law.
Huh. Really?
Yeah. It doesn't meet the standard
for
sterilization. So you can't do it.
Did you see the Matt Damon movie?
I did. I liked it.
What did you think? I mean, obviously parts of it are going to artistic license and some buy-in. But
Yeah. I mean, there are things that are problematic with it, you know. But by and large, what I like about it is that it focuses on science as a real activity.
Mm-hmm.
So there's no, you know, aliens that save Matt Damon or anything. I hope that's not a spoiler. But
what? You're kidding. You ruined it for me. Now I don't want to go see it.
But he uses science, and it's science in a positive light, which is really nice to see.
And we're not going there and destroying things, right?
I mean,
we're out of curiosity, we're going there to sort of investigate the planet, and he just happens to get stuck.
That fascinates me that there's international law regarding what we can do on other planets. I did not know that.
There's been a whole series of treaties for decades.
I have had a love of astronomy since I was a little kid, and they opened the Strassenberg Planetarium when I was a little boy, so that was kind of maybe what fueled it. What is your fascination with this, and why do you think it's important that we go beyond our planet?
I think what's really fascinating about this is how much you can learn about the wondrous nature of the universe. That it's very easy to fall into our own little world and think of our own selves. And I think one of the things that astronomy does is it paints a much bigger picture. You know, it's what Carl Sagan said was the pale blue dot. Mm. When you look back at the Earth and you realize that all of our fights and all of our conflicts are on this little rock, and how really they should be much more insignificant than they are.
Mm.
I like that. So there's a philosophical bend to this as well. So again, if you haven't seen the movie The Martian, Brian gives it a 2 thumbs up.
Yep. Nice.
What kind of emoji would you give it? A smiley face emoji?
And where can people read your blog?
You can reach it at briankoberlein.com.
Okay.
briankoberlein.com.
All right.
From RIT. Thanks so much. It's great to have you in the studio.